Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you that how to create this graph walk cycle in PowerPoint 2016 or 2019. So here we have four different presentations, and let me show you each of them to explain you some few basic techniques of PowerPoint using which you can create any kind of 2D animation, not only this graph walk cycle. So I have created this four different presentations to explain you some basic PowerPoint techniques. So as you can see that this presentation with outlines. So here you can see some extra outlines with the legs. So if I move it right here, then you can see that I have created two separate rounded corner rectangles and joined them together to create a custom anchor point. So whenever I want to rotate these legs, either using the rotation tool or using the spin animation effect, then I can easily do that because I have defined custom anchor point to each of these legs. However, on the first layer of this presentation, these left and right legs has been grouped together. But if I move to the second slide, then you can see that we now have further two more objects here. And that is because I want to move this leg. So I ungrouped it and now I can easily rotate it. So the animation is very simple. If you see, on each of these slide, let me undo this. On each of these slide, we have positioned the leg in different degrees. So when I run the slideshow, what it does, if I go to the transitions tab, here you can see that I have not applied any transition on any of the slide. What I am only doing is I have select this advanced slide after 0.10 seconds for the first slide. And you can note down the timings of each of the slide, and every slide is staying there only for 0.10 seconds. So what happened when I run the slideshow, all these slides continuously run within 0.90 total timing, and that way it shows you this graph walk cycle. So however, it is standing on the same position. So let me show you the second presentation, and that is without outlines. And here you can see the same graph. And this time I have removed the extra outlines using the shape outline, no outline feature. And if I refill with it the black color, then you can see the extra rectangle which has been grouped together. So let me undo this. And on this presentation, the same technique has been used, and just I have removed the outlines of the extra rectangles. Here you can also notice that on the second slide, it moved its right leg, one of the right leg, and on the third slide you can see a little bit difference between the position of the crab. So here on the fourth slide it moved a little bit further than fifth, sixth, seventh, and you can see that it is moving continuously. So when I run the slideshow, then not only it is moving its leg, but it is also moving forward. So that is the technique that you can use to create animation in the characters. That is one of the technique. Otherwise, you can also use the spin animation effect on these leg, and you can make this animation on a single slide using the spin animation. And you can further also go with the motion path, and you can move that crab further away if you want to using the motion paths. Now let me show you the third slide. And here on the third slide, as you can see that it is without movement. And if I show you the slideshow, then 9 of these slides will run within 0.90 seconds, and that way it will create the animation. And then we have the last presentation with movement, and that is same like the second presentation. But here I would like to show you one thing, that I have drawn these guidelines. You can watch one of my videos on the guidelines, and I have drawn these guides to make the exact position of the legs. And when I want to move the crab further away, then I can easily do that by noting down the gap between the vertical guides. So if I want to move it a little bit further, then I can note down that how much I have moved using these guides. And on the ruler, you can also note down the measurement between the movements. And you can turn on this ruler by going to the view tab and by clicking on this ruler option. So in short, if I tell you, then if I go to the home tab and open the selection pane, then you can see that on the first slide we only have three objects here. One is the body, right leg and left legs. On the second slide, I replicated the same slide by right-clicking on it and choose duplicate slide. On the second slide, what I did, I ungrouped these right legs and then I just selected this one and rotated it just like that. So you can see that the rotation point is according to the custom anchor point that I have defined using the second rectangle and attached it with the first one. Now you can see the rotation according to the movement. So on the second slide, I dropped it right here. Let's say right here. And if you want to move the position, then you can select all the objects. Either you can use the arrow keys or you can also move it by holding the shift key and then move it a little bit further. So repeating the same steps, you can again duplicate the same slide, and this time you can move this leg a little bit and you can also move the entire crab a little bit further. So you can see the animation. If you scroll over the slide, then you can note down the animation. So using this technique, you can create 1 second animation within 10 or 12 slides, and then you only need to move the objects as you want them in the animation instead of applying the animation effects. So that is why this tutorial was a little bit important. So I hope you will like this video and let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and